What is everything?
अभी तो happiness और sadness की बात होगी ना तो
No, do you have to go somewhere and experience it, or is that anyway happening daily? See, the thing is, whenever somebody says that I need to go out and experience, he's in a way, in fact pretty directly, suggesting that right now life is shorn of experiences and I need to do something special. Experiences are out there somewhere in the distance. I mean, what is happening right now, do you consider it a lesser experience? When you say experience everything, what is everything? This is everything. Where else is everything? In the distance? In the future? But then that's what we mean. What do you mean by experiencing? What kind of experience do you want? And when you say I want to experience, ask yourself, are you not saying that I prefer one kind of experience over the other? When I say I want to experience something, I am probably saying that I want to go and jump into a waterfall. Now, are you not already labeling that as an experience and this as a non-experience? You already decided. And this decision is an experience which you do not know to be an experience. I'm not getting it. What is the mind doing? The mind is saying that waterfall is an experience. And this
right now
is not an experience. And it is not, and you are not realizing that the mind that is deciding this is in itself an experience. Experience that. Not getting it. There is something happening. What is happening? There is a judgment happening. And who will experience that judgment? To experience something is to become one with it. Experience it, that how the mind is in the search of the far and the elusive, that which cannot be obtained. And it's going after that. When we say be open to experience, that does not mean that go and run to some far off place. Travel to the Mars, jump into the Pacific Ocean. No, that's not what is meant. Being open to experience means be open right now, and everything is an experience.
Just like be joyful right now. जो हम बोलते हैं कि joy के लिए कहीं वहाँ नहीं जाना है, यहाँ नहीं जाना.
Somehow meant in terms of conditioning. Like, for me, like, it's the, I get to hear that you don't experience sadness, like, you know. So that is what I meant, ki the, yeah.
Yeah, but even conditioning, tell me, when does it work?
Yeah, exactly.
When does it work? When is the work of conditioning happening? Right now.
Yeah.
So even if you want to experience conditioning, even if conditioning is to be experienced, all that experience has to be right now. Are you not seeing the game of conditioning right now? Is conditioning not at work right now? I want to face my fears. Now, will the fear suddenly pop up at some point in time?
Yeah.
Are you not afraid right now?
Yeah.
Have the fears gone to sleep right now? You are afraid even right now.
Mm.
Face it. Look at it. Live in it.
Mm. Why is man always in search, or is always after adrenaline rush, or you know, they want to experience something, you know, people these days bungee jumping, this, that, they want to experience something extraordinary.
Because something extraordinary is there to be experienced. It is waiting to be experienced. You see, it's like this. There are these two nostrils that you can breathe from, right? Huh? What happens when one of them is choked? How do you feel? But will you die?
No.
You'll keep living. But how will you keep feeling? These are the two dimensions in which man must live. The dimension of duality, the dimension of non-duality. And they are simultaneous. If you start living only in one dimension, you will not die physically. But you will keep feeling choked and suffocated. So then there is a desperate attempt to do something about it. You take a stick and you poke it into your nose, and there are many kinds of things that you might want to do. That's what people are doing, picking up sticks and pushing them up there. So some kind of excitement might be
desperate
there.
Attempts.
Yeah,
desperate
attempts
to live.
To live. The only problem is one of them is choked.
Yeah.
And you know which one. You very well know which one. And not only is one of them choked, what happens when one nostril is choked? What effect does it have upon the other? The other one will be overworked.
Yeah.
And you can't even enjoy the other one. Probably the other one will become inflamed after a few days due to being overheated. So there has to be this world, and in this world a constant remembrance of what this world is. I'm not using the word other world. I'm saying this world and a constant remembrance of what this world is. And in this remembrance there is the other. And in this remembrance there is the other.
This applies to rebellion also.
It's all a part of this world. Nothing is prohibited as such. And it is happening. You have no control over it. It is happening. It's just that when it is happening, know that it is happening. And that's it.